Dear viewers, every day we are meeting new and new political turmoil. In multi-party democracy like India, frequent uprise of such political row is very common. We can change the ruling party in the next election, but there must be a permanent and neutral administrative system on which both opposition and citizen can rely on. Institutions like CBC, CBI, Judiciary Election Commission would play such a role in our democracy. But nowadays, even constitutional bodies do not go beyond our doubt. On 13th January beginning this year, people of India have already witnessed the feud between the former Chief Justice of India Deepak Mishra and other four senior judges, one of which is now our present Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi. Four judges themselves released a rare press briefing to speak out against Deepak Mishra over his choice for judges to hear potentially sensitive cases. The people of India cannot still understand whether such body is really impartial. Recently, two Thomas CBI officers also exploded openly accusing each other of corruption. Doubt behind the credibility and reliability of such institution is being strengthened in the minds of people. If constitutional bodies become politically biased, if anti-corruption agencies become corrupted, if such things continue to happen, then what will be the future of our democracy? Ongoing disturbance at CBI is a matter of great concern for the nation. There are many interrogations against the government too, and doubts behind the interim measure they have taken to handle the situation. We will dissect and study the whole case, but make sure that you have subscribed this channel and press the bell icon to get notified for future updates on such different important issues. First, have a close view on the CBI incident and then I will highlight the points of doubt. CBI received a complaint from a Hyderabad-based businessman Satish Babu Sana against the present Special Director of CBI Rakesh Asthana. Sana claimed that he was a witness in the case of meat exporter Moin Qureshi, who was facing a number of cases of money laundering and corruption. Special investigation team headed by Asthana was investigating the Qureshi case. Sana has claimed that he has paid 3 crore to Asthana through a Dubai-based middleman Manoj Prasad and his brother Somesh Prasad to save him in the case. On developing the case, CBI Director Alok Verma lodged an FIR against Asthana on 21st October Sunday. Next day, that is Monday, Deputy Superintendent of Police Devender Kumar, who was earlier the investigation officer in the Qureshi case, was held for purported falsification of records in the bribery allegation against Asthana. Next day, that is 23rd October Tuesday, CBI Chief Alok Verma divested the CBI Special Director Rakesh Asthana of all power when it was 9 PM at night. Soon at that midnight at about 12:30 AM, that is 24th October Wednesday, the appointment committee of the cabinet served an order divesting the CBI Director Alok Verma of power and appointing the Joint Director M Nageswar Rao as Interim Director of CBI. Thus, both the first and second chief of CBI were discharged of all power and the feud came to light. Now, there raises some point of interrogation against the government. Why has the appointment committee divested Alok Verma? He rather tried to recover the fair image of CBI which Asthana has tarnished. People will think that it is rather a punishment for Alok Verma for discharging BJP's blue-eyed boy Rakesh Asthana, who is an IPS officer from Gujarat cadre and successfully handled some potentially and politically sensitive cases like Godhra, Agastya Westland, Vijay Mallya case, Rajasthan ambulance case, etc. and gave a quick result to the advantage of BJP. Discharging the director Alok Verma is rather a violation of Section 4 of Delhi Special Police Establishment Act. Which section did CBC use to remove Verma? In terms of both Lokpal Act and Supreme Court judgment in Jain Halala case, CBI director has a fixed tenure of 2 years. Government cannot curtail its tenure or take interim measure without the meeting of collegium consisting of the Prime Minister of India, Chief Justice of India and the Leader of Opposition. The reason behind the removal of CBI director is not satisfactory to us. The Central Vigilance Commission argues the grave allegation of corruption by senior functionaries of CBI one against another, which has been widely reported in media, has vitiated the official ecosystem of the organization. That is why both of them must sit out on leave. Now the question is, who has charged allegation against Verma? Does the allegation come from outsider like Sana or something one else or someone else? The charged person, a charged person, Asthana himself lodged dozens of charges against Verma. It's very common that an alleged person will do the same to save himself. If this allegation against Verma was correct or true, then why was Asthana silent before the complaint against himself? The collapse of ecosystem within the CBI was known to all even 2 years ago. Since Rakesh Asthana was appointed as the Special Director of CBI, Verma could not receive him warmly. What was the need of appointing a Special Director while there was the post of a Joint Director? The distinction between the role of a Joint Director and the Special Director was not clear. Opposition parties often claim that it was a political recruitment. Rakesh took favour of lone defaulter Chetan Sandesara. Alok Verma constituted probe into the wedding of Asthana's daughter in 2012. So why government delay to took into the case of their functional feud? If they can wait for 2 years, why did they take action against Verma so immediately at that very night? Only 2 hours after Verma had charged Rakesh, the Supreme Court has ordered that the interim director M Nageswar will only do routine duties of CBI. Then what will be the future of those important cases which Verma was investigating? MK Stalin again alleges when CBI is investigating Gulkha scam and the Madras High Court has ordered an investigation against Tamil Nadu Chief Minister K. Palanaswamy for awarding contract to his relatives, the move to send CBI Director Verma on leave is suspicious. Whatever the case may be, misuse of government machinery, interference in the administration and corruption within the government agencies will surely cause disaster. We the people of India only want a fair and corruption-free administration which will serve our nation with integrity, credibility and reliability. It is the duty of our ruling party to be our real guardian and protect these pillars of democracy. They must attain public faith, not because they have taken oath to do so, but because they have to face the upcoming general election in next year.